We're in Hancock, Minnesota. We farm just about 5,000 acres, and we raise primarily corn and 1,300 acres of kidney beans. And I've been farming full-time since 1997. Today we're going to be looking at irrigation systems. We're going to be talking about center pivot irrigation and a new concept called a rain machine. So center pivot irrigation is just like we see here. It's anchored in the middle and just goes round and round. The new concept rain machine is an irrigation machine that runs down the corn rows, drops the water at the base of the plant for maximum efficiency. The main benefit of the rain machine would be efficient irrigation, hopefully less water usage, manure application, precise placement of nutrients, fungicides, things like that. The rain machine is a beta machine at this point, so this is our first year with it. It's an alpha machine born about 3 years ago, and alpha is prototype basically. Beta's been in production 1 or 2 years. It's doing its job as far as application. We've had some software issues, we've had a few mechanical issues, everything that you would expect in a beta machine. The goal is that the rain machine will use less water because we're going to apply it efficiently. There's limiting factors on the rain machine that on a 150-acre field, we're limited to about 6 inches of water per year. The question is going to be, in a drought year like this, is that going to be enough? My gut feeling is, in a drought year like this, on soils with limited water holding capacity, the rain machine is probably going to be capable of about 100 acres. The soil type in this particular field is sandy loam with water holding capacity of about 2 inches. We have all kinds of different soils on our farm. We have class one soils that'll hold 6 inches of water and all the way down to coarse gravel. The rain machine will go on any kind of soil. It all depends on the kind of year that you're gonna have. I'm gonna say it's gonna go on more of a medium soil that's gonna have more of an average water holding capacity. The cost of a rain machine is about $150,000, which is very similar to a center pivot with a corner arm on it. A center pivot with a corner arm on it would water approximately 150 acres, the same as a rain machine, so the cost is similar. So with a corner system irrigation watering 150 acres with a 600 gallon per minute well, I can put on approximately 1.4 inches per week of water. With a rain machine, the maximum capacity is 225 gallons per minute. So on a 150 acre field, I can only put on about a half an inch. A rain machine is just like any other type of irrigation. It can go on any type of crop. There's some benefits in being able to move the rain machine, but I see that primarily in the situation where you would apply manure through it. I don't think you'll be able to move it, efficiently irrigate land because of the limited water applying abilities of it. In a normal rainfall year, I think the rain machine will be as efficient and do an adequate job as an irrigation machine. I have a subsurface drip irrigation system. I have a linear irrigator, so that's an irrigator that walks straight down the rows. And the drip system is, one of the things is it's got lots of zones, so you're able to do different applications in those zones. And I just got to thinking about this linear walking down the field. If there was a way that we could make that so it could apply water variable rate, nitrogen variable rate as it walked down the field. And so I shared this concept with an engineer from 360 Yield Center, and he was very interested in it, and that's where the rain machine was born. I think the potential is fantastic. Like I said, we've had some startup issues where our booster pump didn't come in time, so we couldn't apply enough water. We had some software and mechanical issues, so we couldn't apply all our nitrogen and not enough water. But the potential is there. It's just a matter of getting some of the startup glitches worked out. The reason that the rain machine is potentially important is, personally, I feel that the DNR is going to be cutting us back on the amount of water we can use as time goes on. They've done that in other states where water isn't as available, and they start cutting us back. I believe the Bonanza Valley watershed has already had a reduction in the amount of water they can use. We're blessed here in our watershed where we can pump 14 inches a year, but I don't think that's going to continue. So if we can find an irrigation system that can use half that water and still raise an equal or better crop, that's got to be the ultimate goal.
In general, it's good to be very conservative with water. We have aquifers below us here in Minnesota, and there are parts of the Bonanza Valley where that aquifer is constantly being watched by the Department of Natural Resources and trying to manage that, because we all drink water. and the farmers need water too to water the crops. It is a very precious resource and we don't want to run out of that. Steve had come to me, we were just trying to look at what we could do for this concept of this rain machine. And we have a lot of conversations about that and the benefits that we could see at first. As we know in Minnesota, water is a very valuable resource. It's highly contested. It's not as contested as out west, but it is a valuable resource. Everybody needs water. We need to come up with ways to be more efficient, and Steve is trying to be on the front line of this to be more efficient and be just as productive or more productive, and always trying to think of new ways to get things done. And if this is a way to be more efficient, not having it evaporate, and use less water overall would be the ultimate goal. It's been an interesting year weather-wise. It's in its first year, but it does have promises and places where it could definitely be used. There is always producers looking for better ways to be more efficient with irrigation. Currently, that I am aware of, Steve is the only one in the area that has a rain machine on his farm. We do not know how much more efficient it is just with the first year of data. Just looking at it overall, it's putting it down on the base of the plant instead of above the plant. Right away, you're looking at better water capturing instead of it blowing in the wind or evaporating in the sun. It's being captured more readily by the soil and that growing plant. It's low pressure, so there's not a lot of pressure to have it escape as well. So it's more efficient that way already. Just putting numbers to it can be difficult right now. In agriculture, trying to find ways to be more efficient is always important, and not just being stagnant with what you are, because the culture evolves, the climate evolves, communities evolve. You have to keep moving forward. And farmers are always trying to push the, how can they be more efficient to either be more profitable or just do it better with less? Because they need to think of ways to be that efficient and be on that cutting edge center of it. And that's part of what we're here today for, is to tell a little bit of a story of what Steve's trying to do for his farm, but then also to maybe take that to other farms, just show you can be efficient with water.
Okay, so what we're gonna do now is we're gonna turn this machine on. It's at the 50-yard line right now, which is the middle of the field. And that's kind of the line it runs on to go up and down the field. So it comes to the middle and turns, and then water's going down and water's coming back, backs up to the 50-yard line, and then drives into the next pass, and water's going up and coming down. When that pass is done, the water shuts off, it backs up, and it gets ready to turn into the next pass. And it's gonna repeat that process all the way across the field. And as soon as it makes its turn, then the pump is going to start and water will start coming out the drop nozzles into the row. And the rain machine does not water the 50-yard line. This is a 3-inch hose. Maximum length that this machine can handle is 3,000 feet. We've got about 2,750 feet on our reel right now. And this is the supply hose that runs from the well and then runs out and supplies water to the rain machine. It lays down as the machine goes and wraps back up as the machine comes. There is never any tension on this hose. It's coming.
How fast does it move?
Right now, the machine is moving back to us at a pace of about 7 inches a second. That is full speed. And it's wrapping the hose up. Now we're turning into the next pass. And once it turns in now, the water will come on. It's all a timing thing built into the software, based on the speed of the machine. And so right now we're running at 15 PSI, 7 gallon a minute. So it's probably actually putting out 5 to 6.
The corn is tall enough right now that it's pushing buttons on the panel when it's driving.
So they have to figure that out.
So we've been working through that as well.
Yeah, just have to put some kind of a shield on it.
Yeah.
That's accessible so we can get at them.
We can see that the well is on. Booster's on. We got our injection pump for nitrogen is off right now.
And there it is, right on that green line, and headed down the...
Yep, there's our outbound path right there. So all the blue paths would be what it's already completed.
Nice.
Black paths are where it's heading next.
That's crazy, all from the tablet.
Yeah.
Yeah.
This is a very simple, basic variable rate plan, but there isn't any reason we can't variable rate all the way across the field wherever there's slope.
It looks like a lot of water, but it really isn't.
Well, look at this, though. It's not that.
No, it's really not. Then it's at the base where it needs it.
So our goal then is to apply our fungicides like this. Maybe there's foliar micros we can apply like this. Just think, I can put on my nitrogen in season, my potash in season. It's just like banding, except it's after the crop is up.
Correct.
one of the things that drove this, I'm in the watershed where they cut back nitrogen usage. We can apply fungicides and insecticides with center pivots along with nitrogen, the same as the rain machine. The difference is we can use a lot less water to apply our fungicides and insecticides with a rain machine versus a center pivot. With a center pivot, we're applying about 2,700 gallons an acre of water. With a rain machine, we're applying about 260 gallons. Last year was an extremely drought year, more so than 2022 has been, and we applied the maximum water we could, about 14 acre inches to the land. This year, we're setting right about 6 inches of water applied at this point. So the way we set this up is maybe not the conventional way, but it's the way it worked for us. We left our irrigation well in place, and part of the reason was is we wanted the ability to run our pivot on half the field in case the rain machine didn't provide adequate enough water. So we left our irrigation well here. This well is about 90 feet-ish, probably put in about 1990 maybe. Put a flow meter on it so we know our total gallonage, and then we tie it in a T. We can open it up and run it to the pivot, or we can close it and just run to the rain machine, or we can open both and run both. This here is a 3-inch hose, and we put a variable frequency drive on it so that we can run it based on pressure. So if we're only running the rain machine, the well pump is running at maybe 20% capacity, only putting out 225 gallons a minute. If we're running both at the same time, we're putting out 860 gallons a minute and running the rain machine and the pivot at the same time. So that's the way we installed ours for flexibility this year. In the future, we may just go with a brand new pump that provides the pressure we need. There's a booster pump underneath here, and the reason for it is we have to create 115 to 20 pounds of PSI at the wellhead to get 5 PSI at the end of our hose 2,800 feet away. And so we have to generate that pressure here. So we added a booster pump, and it only runs when the rain machine's running. This is just an off-the-shelf 18 gallon per hour injection pump, and you can adjust between 3 gallons per hour and 18 gallons per hour the product that you're injecting into your stream so you can apply the proper amount of product. So I've got a relationship with NRCS that stretches back a few years. Cory's been wonderful to work with and has helped us. We've done individual sprayer nozzle control. We did a program for that. We've done cover crops. We've done irrigation management. We've done soil moisture probes, nitrogen management, and we did some filter strips. And those programs have all been wonderful for us. They're providing a source of funding that has allowed us to do them that we probably would not have done.
Working with Steve has been excellent. I started out working with Steve. A lot of it was conversations, building a relationship just to feel comfortable. And I think the biggest thing was when I came and visited with Steve on his farm to look at what did he want to do. We've done some cover crops. We've also done the soil moisture probes was a big thing. And then we also did irrigation water management. And it was not just the basic checkbook. It was using computer apps and software and programs to manage that water as so he can be as efficient as he can be. We also went into doing acres that followed University of Minnesota nitrogen and fertilizer recommendations. We also did true precision chemical application with the sprayer. It was individual nozzles. It wasn't sections. It was individual nozzles and mapping and chemical records. So glad to work with Steve and continue to work with Steve.
My experience with NRCS has been wonderful. I would recommend to other producers to try to search out the programs that might work for them. Some of them might not be exactly what you want to do, but if you're willing to bend a little, there's some dollars out there that could really benefit your operation.
I've worked with Steve for, I think it's actually been almost 8 years. Steve has always had an idea, and it's how can we make this work with the conservation programs, or what assistance can I provide to Steve? It's exciting. It's been great working with Steve. There's options. He's receptive to things that I'll give him an idea, hey, let's do this, and he knows what he wants to do. Producers that are interested in precision agriculture or any practices that we have, I would strongly recommend that you go talk to your local field office, or I encourage you to ask them to come out to you and have them visit with you on your farm. We'd love to come visit you. I encourage you to contact NRCS. You might be surprised that there is a practice or a program that would fit your operation and that you might not have thought of.